Hi there, my name is Love Johor and I have a very strong information technology security portfolio. I have an extensive work experience and knowledge in information technology, IT security, ISMS and ISO 27001, and I have also worked with different security companies in the past career. So I have basically created this channel in order to help anyone who is currently trying to study or planning to study about ISMS, that is Information Security Management System, and ISO 27001 implementation. So in this particular channel, I will try to give you some pre-study material, relevant documentation, and any other support that you'll be needing for any of the topics that I'll be discussing here. So basically, I want to share my entire ISMS journey and experience with all of you out there so that you don't have to go through all the different paths and different routes that I have went through while I was studying my ISO 27001 for the first time. So all the things that I will be explaining here will be real-time scenarios from my own experience and not just theoretical knowledge. So what we will see in this particular video is some different terms and technology and terminologies which are used in ISO 27001 and ISMS, you know, implementation. So if in case you are confused by a data security acronym, abbreviation or expression, or any information security jargons for that matter, this particular video is for you and it will definitely help you out, trust me. And here are some key terms that will actually help you in becoming IC 27001 certified. So let's start with understanding what do we mean by non-repudiation. What is non-repudiation? So non-repudiation is nothing but the ability to prove the occurrence of a claimed event or action and its originating entities. So it means that non-repudiation is nothing but a way of guaranteeing that people cannot later deny that an event happened or an action was actually carried out by them. So let's take a live example. So for example, a user is authenticated according to multiple factors before performing a financial transaction online on a bank website, right? So this makes it more difficult for the user to dispute a transaction that he has made by using his own credentials on the online portals, except in case where he has actually lost those credentials. So in that case, he can obviously, you know, file a complaint and tell it to the bank, but otherwise he cannot deny those transactions. So this is how non-repudiation works. And next, let's try to understand what do we mean by statement of applicability, and why do we need statement of applicability, which is also called SOA, SOA document. A written statement describing the controls and their objectives that are relevant to an organization's SMS is basically called the statement of applicability. And the purpose of this document is to define which controls are appropriately implemented in the organization, what are the objectives of these controls and how are they implemented, as well as to approve residual risks and formally approve the implementation of the said controls. So in nutshell, SOA identifies the controls that you have selected to address the risks that were identified in your risk assessment process, and it basically explains why those controls have been selected, and it states whether or not they have been implemented, and explains why some of the controls in Annex A of ISO 27001 have been omitted. So as such, SOA document provides an effective outline of the entire ISMS, you can say that. So after SOA, let's try to understand what exactly do we mean by a threat. What is a security threat? So threat is nothing but the potential cause of an incident that may result in a breach of information security or compromise business operations. So threat is basically a potential cause of an unwanted incident which may result in harm to any asset or to a complete organization. So let's try to take a real life example of basically trying to understand how exactly a threat functions. So a threat basically exploits a vulnerability to impact an asset. For example, let's take some different examples. It can be classified either natural or man-made. So physical damage like fire, water, floods, etc. could be there as threats. Natural events like volcanic events and loss of essential services like electrical power, air conditioning, telecommunication, etc. Could be, triggered as threats. And compromise of information, for example, eavesdropping, theft of media, retrieval of discarded materials, which can actually result in, threats for information security. So after threats, let's try to understand what exactly do we mean by vulnerability. What is a vulnerability? So vulnerability is nothing but the weakness of an asset or control that can be potentially exploited by one or more threats. So let's try to take a real life example in order to better understand what does a vulnerability means. So an attacker finds and uses an open port on a web server or any, open port on any server. He can actually find an open port in order to install a malware or to export sensitive data. So this is how a vulnerability works. A person actually tries to find out, how many open ports are there on a server, and then he can actually exploit it. This is how the hacking works, basically. And after that, let's try to understand what do we basically understand by information processing facility and why do we need an information processing facility in the first place. So information processing facility or a system is basically any information processing system, service or infrastructure, or basically the physical location housing these things. For example, a data center which has all the servers and network equipments is a information security information processing facility. And at the same time, all the equipments which are present inside the data center can also be called as information processing facility. But please remember that the facility can be either an activity or a place, and it can be either tangible or intangible. For example, a web hosting service which is hosted on a web server could also be a part of the information processing facility. So now let's try to understand what exactly do we mean by information security. So information security is nothing but preservation of confidentiality, integrity and availability of information, and the purpose of information security is to only protect and preserve the confidentiality, integrity and availability of information. That is the main purpose of having information security in the place. So that's it for this particular training video. In the upcoming training videos, I will try to cover some more ISMS and ISO 27001 terms and definitions, since there are different terms and definitions out there. So that's it for this particular video, and I request you to please subscribe to my channel if you are really interested in order to study ISO 27001 and understanding its implementation. So information security management system is a very vast topic. So I would request all of you out there that you subscribe to get the most knowledge out of these videos. If you have any questions, please feel free to comment below and I will be really happy to respond. This is Love Johar. Thank you.